this, Lord? Do you find it hard to sit with me tonight? I've walked these miles, but I've walked them straight line.
Hi, London Grammar. Nice to see you. It's a pleasure to talk to you. We are in the Transmusicale, and it's a quite famous festival in France. Very exciting for all the bands. How about you, when you knew that you were coming here? Was it special somehow for you?
Our fans over here in this area of the world have been so supportive of us, so it always feels amazing to come back. This festival is an honour, and it's also our last show of the year, so...
Did you get a bit emotional on stage for that?
I did. I thought I was going to cry and wasting my young years.
If you took the end of the record, that to me is more clubbing than the beginning, and you spread it to a whole concert, it's like the end of the record continuing. Did you work like that, your live performance?
I think that was something, I suppose it was something we tried to do. We always knew that it would be a little bit more heavy and a little bit more electronic live, because that's what audiences react well with, you know, a greater dynamic. So that was all part of like taking a record that we made in the studio and bringing it to the live format.
I'm gonna show you where it's dumped, but have no fear. There's something inside you, it's hard to explain.
To me, I received that record as a diary. 17 days, 17 moods, 17, well, I don't know, heartbreaks or joy. Did you wrote it that way too, like an everyday journal, almost?
Yeah, it's probably a journal that's spread over about 18 months, I guess. It is all introspective and things that you wouldn't want people to read, but then they end up hearing.
To me also the songs, I receive them as letters. Letters to friends, letters to ghosts sometimes, which is probably part of the melancholy.
Yeah, I think that's a really nice way of putting it, because I think a lot of songwriters often write things that they wish that they could say to someone and that they never got the opportunity to, or that you just never would find another expression to say it in a normal conversation. So.
Mummy, please grab my record and listen carefully, track 7 and 8.
While I'm wide-eyed and I'm so down, caught in the middle, I've excused you.
C'est très important pour nous. L'espace dans la chanson, parce que pour utiliser la voix d'Anna de le maximum, c'est très important d'avoir l'espace dans la chanson. Ouais.
If I brought something to the table, what the boys would do around it would be so thought through and particular, or if they've written music before, it's always been really simple but atmospheric and beautiful, and that's half of, you know, more than half of London Grammar is trying to get that balance perfect.
Something that we learned over time, like to deal with each other in that way, to like maximize our, you know, and Hannah's voice and like everything else around us.
Tu as dit l'espace, which it's really important in your music. I think there is time for silence. You play the silences too.
But something we feel live, like as well. I always notice live. We have, nous avons le cinq, five, you know, six, maybe 7 seconds sometimes, and people start to, yeah, but in a good way. So.
Yeah. Well, thank you very much. I'd like to say go run, buy and listen that record. Lots of sweetness and power all together. So that's very nice. Thank you very much.
child.